And finally tonight, we take a look into a new saint canonized by Pope Francis last month, Sister Giuseppina Vannini, founder of the Daughters of St. Camillus. Our EWTN Rome Bureau Chief Alan Holdren tells us her story.
Giuseppina Vannini will be patroness of hospital workers and suffering people. She was born in Rome on July the 7th, 1859, the second of three children. From childhood, Giuseppina dealt with many sufferings, illness, and poverty. At the age of four, she lost her father, and at the age of seven, her mother. Separated from her siblings, Giuseppina grew up in an orphanage near St. Peter's Square on the Janiculum Hill. The promoter of Giuseppina's cause for canonization, Sister Bernadette, knows the life of Blessed Vannini better than anyone else, and she tells us that the experience of living with the sisters helped Giuseppina to choose the consecrated life.
Crescendo con le suore della carità,
growing up with the Sisters of a Charity, on the day of her first communion, she felt the desire in her heart to become a nun herself. When she reached the age of 21, she asked the sisters to join the institute. She was admitted and then later discharged after several unfortunate circumstances. She was then sent back several times and finally discharged for good.
Blessed Vannini never gave up the desire to consecrate herself to God. She continued with the search until she met Chameleon Father Luigi Tezza. God, who permitted Giuseppina to suffer, chose her to alleviate the sufferings of others. The encounter with Father Tezza was the turning point for Mother Vannini's life. After 2 years under his spiritual guidance, on February the 2nd, 1892, Blessed Vannini consecrated herself to God. Sister Laura runs the mother house of the Chameleon Sisters community in Rome. She walks us through Blessed Vannini's room that has now been turned into a museum.
This museum collects some particular items. For example, in this luminous and open cross, we have the very first timetable of the sisters. The cross, the red cross. This cross was placed on Mother Vannini's dress by Father Luigi Tezza on the day of her profession.
Since that moment, the community grew very quickly, and today there are 800 sisters working in 22 countries across four continents. Her charisma is strongly present here at the Giuseppina Vannini Hospital in Rome. The head of the cardiological department, Professor Gerardo Anzalone, is proud to show the brand new intensive care unit.
And this care intensive coronary unit is the newest and the most modern in Rome. It consists of 9 beds provided with the safest monitoring system technology, which allows to follow in real time the vital parameters for each patient in order to immediately detect life-threatening arrhythmias and cardiac arrest.
Mother Giuseppina Vannini died at the age of 51 on February 23, 1911. Leaving behind her example of perseverance, care, and love for the suffering. Mother Vannini was beatified by St. John Paul II on October 16, 1994, and was able to be canonized because of the miracle involving Brazilian construction worker Arno Klauk, who fell down an elevator shaft.
It happened in the north of Brazil, in the state of Mato Grosso. A worker fell from the third floor of a building under construction, about 11 meters deep, and after the fall was not injured at all.
Mother Vannini's simplicity in daily life, faithfulness to God's call, and abundant love for those who suffer led her to the glorious throne of God.
And our thanks to Alan Holdren and our team in Rome for that story.